Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Civil with Sudhir. So today in this video we are discussing about some SSC JEE, KPSC AE, JEE, that is the BMC subject we have completed, and we are now starting the some 500 question series about the previous year question paper from 2005 to 2018. Very, very important questions I am covering with the explanation, with the answers. Please like, comment and share this video, as well as join our Telegram channel with the name of Civil with Sudhir only in the Telegram channel. Okay, let's begin friends with the first question. First of all, I will take the pen. 1 minute. Yes, I think it is visible. Okay, so let's begin. First question, that is the process of providing smooth face and regular face to the stone is known as. So process of providing smooth face, process of, 1 minute, process of providing the process of providing smooth face and regular face to the stone is called as dressing. So first of all, understand what is squaring and what is seasoning and what is pitching. So seasoning of stone is similar to the removing the moisture. Important point, only in single point you have to understand. Seasoning is nothing but removing the moisture from the stone or timber or anything. So this moisture, that moisture we call it as, that is having a natural moisture. This moisture is called as sap, right? The stones, when we store for removing the what moisture content, that we, that water when it comes out, that we call it as sap. Drying of stone from the quarry sap is known as seasoning of the stone. So what is dressing? Giving the perfect shape and size to the stone. So that is about the first question. Next one is, following stone is suitable for damp proofing. Which of the following stone is you are suitable for damp proofing? So slate is always we will use for damp proofing, because first of all, understand what is mean by damp proofing. So damp proofing is an construction type of moisture control technique applied to building walls, right? So walls, floors and roofs, to prevent moisture passing into the interior space by using the damp proofing material. So what are the different damp proofing material now? Flexible material, beard and rubber, hot bitumen, plastic sheet. Semi-rigid material, mastic asphalt. Rigid material like impervious brick, stones, slates, cement mortar or cement concrete painted with bitumen. So these are the common material we are using. These are the common material they will use for the damp proofing. So slate is the answer for this question. Slate is the answer for this question. Next one. Next question. Quartzite and marble are by nature. Quartzite and marble are by nature, they are metamorphic rock. Right? They are metamorphic rock. So metamorphic rock, whenever the metamorphic rock will come, you should only remember two points. That is extreme heat and heat and pressure, HP. Extreme. Whenever you will see the this word heat and pressure, so you have to take directly metamorphic rock. You have to take directly the metamorphic rock. So metamorphic rocks are formed by change in characteristics of pre-existing rocks when subjected to great heat and pressure. Right? Great heat and pressure. Heat and pressure. So the answer for this question is metamorphic rock. Next question. Sub classification. Nodi illi question with answer kodta idinalla. New just only question nodi. Okay. Who are watching this video? Just I am requesting all of you, only read the question. Don't see directly answer and try yourself first, then just see the answers. Okay, subclassification of sedimentary rocks, very, very important question. So subclassification of sedimentary rocks is, that is mechanical, chemical and organic. So what are those subclassifications? Are in mechanical, subclassification of sedimentary rocks are made from mechanical weathering, right? Weathering is nothing but any changes in their existing property due to some natural effects like rain, wind or anything, right? So that we call it as weathering. So due to mechanical weathering, that we call it as clastic rock or mechanical rocks. Chemical or non-clastic rocks, that is made up of chemical weathering of limestone. If it is changed by chemical weathering, that is we call it as chemical rock classification. And the third one is organic rocks. Right. So answer for this question is B. Next, under heat and pressure, just understand this one now. Under heat and pressure, but they are asking for the granite can transfer into. These are the very important questions. Okay, this type of questions are very important. These are in repetitive manner they will ask, and you should remember this tabular column. Very important, very important question. Very important, because some of will just neglect this. They will might not be asked, but this is very important question. So under heat and pressure, granite can transfer into gneiss. Granite can transfer into gneiss. Just remember some other rocks also, right, by seeing this table. So granite is an igneous rock, it converted into metamorphic rock, that is gneiss. And basalt is igneous rock and it is converted into laterite. Limestone is a sedimentary rock and it is converted into marble after heat and pressure. Mudstone is sedimentary rock and converted into slate. Sandstone will sedimentary rock and converted into metamorphic rock as in quartzite. This is very important. This question is very important. In SSC, JEE, every year they will ask one question from this topic. Right? So one question from this topic. सबको समझ में आ रहा है ना? Very important है. बिकॉज हर ईयर इसको रिपीट क्वेश्चन होता ही होता है एक मास का. जो आज जो भी हमारे वीडियो में है रॉक्स के बारे में हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं. पूरा रॉक्स आज चैप्टर हम कर देंगे. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द नेचुरल बेडिंग प्लेन ऑफ स्टोन्स एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रेशर इन स्टोन मेसनरी इज. राइट, देखिए यहाँ पे एक उन्होंने क्वेश्चन क्या पूछे, आंसर मत देखिए. सभी को एक रिक्वेस्ट है, प्लीज आंसर मत देखिए, बिकॉज मैं आपको एक्सप्लेनेशन बाद में करूंगा. आप खुद से ट्राई कीजिए, फर्स्ट ट्राई योर सेल्फ फर्स्ट, देन जस्ट सी द आंसर. एंड एवरी आफ्टर रीडिंग एवरी क्वेश्चन आई विल गिव यू 5 मिनट्स. डोंट सी द आंसर. नेक्स्ट वीडियो में मैं कुछ इसको अल्टरनेट करने की कोशिश करूंगा ताकि आपको आंसर ना दिख सके, आप ट्राई करें. ठीक है, तो नेचुरल बेडिंग प्लेन ऑफ स्टोन्स एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रेशर इन द स्टोन मेसनरी इज ऑलवेज नॉर्मल. हाउ, जस्ट रिमेंबर, जस्ट और जस्ट सी दिस दिस स्केच. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल दीज आर द स्टोन्स, राइट, दीज आर द स्टोन्स आर लेड हियर, द प्रेशर वी विल अप्लाइड हियर, राइट. So the direction of pressure in the stone masonry is kept perpendicular to the natural bedding plane of the stones. So the natural bedding plane of the stones and the direction of pressure in the stone masonry, right, always normal. In the case of stone walls, the position of the stone blocks should be same in which they were originally deposited. This position gives maximum strength to the stone work in the wall. It means if they applied the stone on this this stone, or if they applied the pressure, right, so this is what their natural bedding plane of stone in masonry, right? When we see this is this is cross section, right? So you can see easily if you applied, so it is normal to the bedding plane, right. Next question. So granite is a rock that is by nature. So what is a granite? Is a plutonic rock. Very important, right? But as we know, granite is an igneous rock, but they have not given the option. If they given, you can directly tick. But granite is a plutonic rock. Okay, if you know not understand this granite or rocks, please go through our classes, you will understand easily. So the answer for this question is plutonic rock. Next question, basalt stone by nature. So basalt stone by nature is an volcanic rock. Basalt stone by nature is an volcanic rock. Just understand, you have two different types, that is intrusive or extrusive, or plutonic or volcanic. So what do you mean by the intrusive? Is nothing but these are formed beneath the earth surface after cooling the crystallization of the magma, right? So they will just at the below of the ground. This is ground level. They will just below the ground level. So example for this type of rocks are granite, gabbro, diorite. So these are the examples of plutonic rock or intrusive rocks. Extrusive is nothing but they will come to the surfaces. These are formed at the earth surface after cooling the crystallization of the magma. Example basalt and andesite. So these are the example of plutonic and volcanic. Okay. Next one. Crushing strength of good building stone should be more than 100 megapascal or 100 newton per millimeter square. So this is also an answer. Right? If they given in newton per minute, that also 100. Right? If they change something, so if they given in other dimension, you have to convert. But you have to remember this is 100 newton per millimeter square is a perfect answer for this question. Very very simple and very very important. Next is the most suitable stone for building piers. Simple and very easy. The most suitable stone for building piers, always we will use granite, because granite having very good compressive strength. First of all, 1 minute. So granite having very good compressive strength, as well as it having good durability compared to other stones. Okay, iska compressive strength acha hai, durability bhi acha hai, aur specific gravity bhi iska almost acha hai. Okay, it having, so granite is an igneous rock. It is hard, durable, hence it is suitable for building piers. So uska hi points maine yahan pe discuss kiya hai. So iska answer ho gaya granite. So the answer for this question is granite. Next question. 1 minute. Hardness of the rock can be tested in situ using hardness of test. We can test by Smith test is for what chemical, and acid test is different, crystallization test is different. So we can use this one. So it is not used for this one, right? Hardness we will not use for Smith test, acid test, crystallization test. So Skimdick hammer rebound test was developed to determine the compressive strength of the concrete. Actually Skimdick hammer test is used for concrete, not for rocks, but in order to calculate the hardness of the stones also we can use that instrument or that test for the rocks, right? To determine, it has also be used for determine the hardness and compressive strength of the rock material. Okay, so answer for this question is Skimdick hammer test. Next question, crushing strength of good building stone should be more than, just this question was asked, but the main changes here is the unit of the question. The unit, in previous question they have asked in 100 megapascal, right? I have told you 100 newton per millimeter square, you have to remember also, right? Now they have given in kg per centimeter square. Just you have to convert this 100 into kg and centimeter square, so you will get this one. You will get this one and some important questions, some important topic, some important discussion about crushing strength of the good building stone is 1000 kg per centimeter square or 100 MPa is the strength of this stone. Crushing test is performed to determine the what crushing strength. Stone sample are cut into cubes of 40 into 40 into 40 mm. Very very important point. So number of samples, how much we have to take? You have to take less than 3, right? Should be 3, not less than 3. So answer for this question is 1000 kg per centimeter square is the crushing strength of good building stone. Okay, next question, rocks having alumina or clay as their major constitution. Very important question, right? Important question, right? We have always remember when the clay content will come, always just remember the argillaceous rock. We have siliceous, where the silica is a predominant factor, right? And we have argillaceous, siliceous, and another one. Can anyone tell me? Just comment. Argillaceous, siliceous, right? And sedimentary rocks, you know the layer by layer structure. Just you have to remember like this. Okay, so argillaceous rocks these are clay predominant, these are brittle and can't withstand shock. As well, the example of this type of stones are slates and laterites. So argillaceous, just remember the clay content, siliceous is silica content, and calcareous, right? Siliceous, argillaceous and calcareous. So if the silica is a predominant factor, okay, just hear my voice. If the silica is a predominant factor, that is a siliceous rock. If an clay is a predominant factor, that is an argillaceous rock. If calcium is a predominant factor, that is a calcareous rock. Remember these points, you can answer any type of question from the rocks. Okay, so answer for this question is the argillaceous rocks. Next question. Which of the following is a rock? Okay, just first of all understand what is rock and what is mineral, right? Rock and mineral. Rock is a natural formation, both are the natural formation, but sometimes the minerals will formed from the rocks, right? The secondary product, we can say secondary product of the rocks, we can say those are the minerals. These are the byproduct, or we can say due to weathering it may changes to other formats or other materials, that we call it as an what? Minerals. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, so rocks and minerals, you just understood the rocks and minerals. 1 minute, I will take the pen. Yes. Okay. Okay, right. So the answer for this question is, which of the following is a rock? So quartzite is a mineral, mica is also a mineral, and gypsum is also a mineral. So answer for this question is none of the above. So none of the above is the answer. So these are all the minerals, correct? Next question. Sandstone is just remember always, sandstone is sedimentary rocks. Sandstone, limestone are what? Sedimentary rocks. And some of the example for igneous rocks are granite, right? And metamorphic rocks, marble, volcanic, just I have told you. Okay, so answer for this question is sedimentary rock. Next, very very important, plaster of Paris is obtained by calcinizing. Next question is, plaster of Paris how will obtained, right? By gypsum, we can say that is an iron, plaster of Paris we will get by quick setting, or gypsum plaster consisting of fine white powder which hardens when moistened and allowed to dry, right? If they allow to dry, right, we will get what? We will get the gypsum. So gypsum is a crystalline mineral of hydrated calcium sulfate, that is CaSO4, CaSO4 2H2O, CaSO4 2H2O, right? When gypsum is heated to 120 to 180 degree Celsius, what will happen? It gets dehydrated to form plaster of Paris. Okay, POP. Okay, idikke antare POP, isko hi bolte hai POP, plaster of Paris. Jab hum 120 se 180 degree tak hum isko kya hai heat karte hai, jab humko kya milta hai, plaster of Paris milta hai. So it is used to precast and hold parts of ornamental plaster work place on ceilings, right? ये ceiling work में ज़्यादा use होता है, right? जो भी हम interior करते हैं ना, वहाँ पे plaster of Paris का ही use करते हैं, because उसको easily mold कर सकते हैं और अच्छा क्या है, वो hold भी कर लेगा, इसीलिए हम use करते हैं. तो answer for this question is gypsum. Next question. Chemically marble is known as, just मैंने आपको बताया था, वो tabular column आपको याद रखना है. Okay, that you have to remember the tabular column of the previous question. So marble is an calcareous rock. Calcium carbonate CaCO3 is a main constituent. We can say again, we have to remember silica and argillaceous and calcium, that is calcareous rock, right? Silica is a predominant factor, clay is a predominant factor, and calcium carbonate is a main constituent. Example for this stone is limestone and marble are the example for this question. Right? Out of the following, which may be termed as an unstratified rocks. Right? Again, you have to remember stratified rocks, unstratified rocks, and foliated rocks. Right? Stratified rocks, unstratified rocks, and foliated rocks. We have three types. Right? Now the question is unstratified rocks. So unstratified rocks is marble. Unstratified rocks is all marble. So stratified and unstratified, right, and foliated, these are always sedimentary. Stratified are always sedimentary. These are igneous rock. Igneous rocks are always unstratified and metamorphic rocks are foliated. Just remember. Okay, now I will write one more time. Right? Stratified. Right? Unstratified. Unstratified and foliated. F-O-L-I-A-T-E-D. Foliated. So stratified is, right? Stratified is what? Sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks we call it as stratified rocks. Unstratified rocks is call it as igneous rocks. And these are metamorphic rocks. Just remember these points, you can understand and you can answer the other questions also. Okay, next one. A stone is rejected if it absorbs the water more than 10%. Right? So 5 to 10% is a range for this one. So 5 to 10%. 5 to 10% is a range of the stone. Next question. An explosive which contains 65% saltpeter and 20% sulfur and 15% charcoal is called is dash. There is the answer. So we just remember this question, they ask on explosive is nothing but when we blasting purpose, when we use for blasting purpose, right? So this is an blasting powder. This is an blasting powder. And they have given dynamite also, they have given nitrocellulose and cordite. So we will discuss the this two also. So blasting powder contains 65% saltpeter, 20% sulfur and 15% charcoal. Right? 15% charcoal. And dynamite contains 75% of nitrocerine and absorbed in 25% of sandy earth forming a thick paste. Right, forming a thick paste. If you want, you can refer the solution also. That's why I have given the solution also for all the questions. So answer for this question is blasting powder. Next is pegmatite is an example of intrusive igneous rocks. Pegmatite is an example of intrusive igneous rock. Pegmatite rock is an example of igneous rocks and it is made up of cooling of solidification of magma. It is cooling of solidification of magma. Right? Next question. Identify the process responsible for the formation of sedimentary rocks. So they are asking about some definition of the sedimentary rocks. So first you should understand what is sedimentary rocks. These are in layer by layer structure. These are we can remove by layer by layer, layer by layer. That you have to remember first one point. So solidification of molten mass of silicates be low or at the surface of the earth. Right? So what we have to identify the process responsible for the formation, how the sedimentary rocks will form it. So this will not form it like this. Next, the changes in texture. Texture is nothing but the what we can say the surface. How it looks and or mineral composition of both igneous and sedimentary rocks due to high temperature and heavy pressure. See, this point is related to what? Metamorphic rock, not about igneous and sedimentary rocks. Whenever the heat and pressure, whenever the heat and pressure will come, it is related to metamorphic rock, not only but it is not related to igneous or sedimentary rocks. So third one, deposited layers of sand and silt subjected to enormous overburden pressures over geological items. This is a very correct answer, because just I have told you it is in layer. If you apply the pressure, it have changes from the thickness will reduce and it will changes to other rocks, right? So the none of the options, this will not come. So the answer for this question is, the C. Okay, next question. Subclassification of sedimentary rocks, right? Subclassification, just I have told you, the question has repeated, sorry. So mechanical, chemical and organic. So thank you friends, my dear friends and my dear students. So this is our first video. Please like, comment, share. How was this video? Please comment in our comment box, as well as like, comment and share. Please subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. Just subscribe our channel. Thank you and all, my dear friends.